Good morning, students. I'm Naima Afin, teacher of class 3 from Mahmudpur branch. Welcome you all. Today is our online video class. Dear students, how are you all? I hope all of you are fit and fine. So before going to start my class, let's congratulate you who obtained good marks in math subject in your second term exam. Congratulations, students! But who did not get good marks in math subject? Will you lose your heart? No, students, don't lose your heart. Don't regret it for your past. From the past, we have to learn that how can we can get good marks in our next exam. Okay, I think if you go ahead with studies every day and practice math every day, then you can also get good marks in math subjects. Students, you know that already we have started our third term syllabus and we have started a chapter that is problem related to addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. From this chapter, you have already done some word problem. So, you know in this term, page 73 will be in our syllabus. So, from page 73, we'll do one problem today. Okay, students? So, take out your CW copy, books and diary also in front of you. Okay, students? So, students, open your book, page 73. From page 73, we'll do today problem number 17. So students, today's our CW number will be 4. So nobody will write now. Students, whenever I will make you understand, nobody will write that time. Okay, after complete my writing, then I will give you some time for write the problem number 17. So look at the question. What is the question for you? And you know, students, before going to start class, you know that from this chapter name, we can easily understand there is the combination of addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. And for that, you have to know the clue word of these four methods. Like addition, what is the clue word of addition? Like together, total, like this way, okay? So I told you in my before video class what is the clue word of this four method: addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. You have to keep in mind, otherwise you cannot understand whatever you have to find out and whatever which method you have to do in the to solve this problem. So look, I am reading out the question here. Surma sold 6 dozen eggs at the rate of taka 90 per dozen. I will read out the full question first, then I will make you understand. From what she got, she spent taka 85 in the market. The remaining amount she deposited in the bank. Now, what amount did she deposit in the bank? It is the asking part. You know, students, that in word problem there are two part: information part and asking part. So they have given you some information from the in the first part. Surma sold 6 dozen eggs at the rate of taka 90 per dozen. It is our information part. And here another information part is, from what she got, she spent taka 85 in the market. The remaining amount she deposited in the bank. So what is the asking part for you? What amount did she deposit in the bank? So dear students, look at the board, then listen here what they are telling you. Shurma sold. Sold means you always, you know, sell. It means sell. 6 dozen. Do you know dozen means? You know, dozen means 12 item can make a dozen. So Shurma sold how many dozen? 6 dozen eggs at the rate of taka 90 per dozen. Look at there. So per dozen means what? This per dozen means 1 dozen. You know, in the work problem sometimes they can give you a, each, every. That means what? We think one. It will be what? One. So per, there is a word per dozen. Per dozen means what? 1 dozen. Clear all of you this point? Okay, now. So students, from what she got? From what she got? We don't know here what she got. How many taka she got by selling 6 dozen eggs? Do you know these things? No, we don't know these things. And without knowing this problem point, we cannot find out the last asking part. That what amount did she deposit in the bank? We cannot find out this question answer. We cannot solve this problem because we have to find out at first that after selling 6 dozen eggs, how much taka she got. Okay, students? So first of all, we have to do these things. And how can I find these things? Can you tell me which method I have to apply here? We have to do here addition, subtraction, multiplication or division. Which method? Can you tell me, students? Yes, very good. You know that Shurma sold 6 dozen eggs at the rate of taka 90 per dozen. That means 1 dozen egg she sold taka 90. So we have to find out 6 dozen eggs price. So that's why we have to do the what? Yes, we have to do the multiplication. We have to do the multiplication here to find out how much taka she got. Okay, students, it is our first part. Without finding these things, we cannot solve our problem. So at first, I am solving here that how much taka she got. That's why I am writing here the price of 1 dozen egg is taka 90. So it is our first part. Easily I can find out the price of 6 dozen. She does not sell 1 dozen egg. She sold 6 dozen egg. But they have told you that so what do you have to do here, students? We are doing here multiplication. So I am writing here 90 multiplied by 6. Okay. 90 multiplied by 6. Look at, students, what I have written here. The price of 1 dozen egg is taka 90. Now we are finding 6 dozen egg price. Then we can easily understand that how much money she got. The price of 6 dozen egg is 90 multiplied by 6. For that, we can do the rough work on here. I am writing here. Now I have to do the multiplication to find out the 6 dozen egg price. Because they have given you what? 1 dozen price is taka 90. And we have to find out 6 dozen egg price. Then we can easily understand how much taka she got. So look at there. 6 zeros are 0. What will be there? 6 zeros are. Tell me. Yes. 6 zeros are 0. And now go to the next part. 6 nines are. Can you tell me what will be the 6 nines are? Tell. 6 nines are will be 54. Very good. So I got the answer here. 540 taka she got after selling 6 dozen eggs. So I got the answer. I am writing the answer here. 540 taka. So it is our first part. But we did not get here. Look, there is 540 taka I have written. It is not our final answer, students. We just got this answer, that from what she got we get the answer now 540 taka. Now what happened, students? It is not our final answer. What will be our last answer? We have to find out this. Look what in the question. She spent taka 85 in the market. There is the word 85 taka in the market she spent. From which money she spent 85 taka? Can you tell me? Yes. She spent this 85 taka from this 540 taka. Okay. So, for that, the next part, what they are telling you? The remaining amount she deposited in the bank. What amount did she deposit in the bank? Look. So remaining means what? Can you tell me what does remaining means? Which method we have to apply here? We have to use which method here? Remaining is the clue word of which method? Can you remember, students? Yes, I think. Yes, it is. We have to do here subtraction to find out the remaining money. Okay, students, we know that how much taka she got from selling. Okay, so we are now finding out that how much taka was remained with her after spent 85 taka in the market. So how can we find the remaining money? By doing the subtraction. I told you before, the remaining money we can find out after doing the subtraction. Look at the board. What I am writing here, I am writing the second part here. She has taka. How much taka she has? We have got find out this answer. She has taka 540 taka. Okay, she has 540 taka, but she does not deposit all the money. From this 540 taka, she spent some taka. So you can easily understand that some money will be less from this 540 taka. Is it clear to you, students? Yes. And after spending some money, the rest of the money she will deposit in the bank. So now I am writing here, she spent, how much taka she spent in the market? Taka 85. So you have to write digit under digit. Whenever we are doing the subtraction, we are doing the addition, we have to write digit under digit. Okay, now we are doing the subtraction. That's why I am giving the subtraction sign. Now here we have to do the subtraction. Look at this board. Do the subtraction now. Here is first part is 0 and the lower part is 5. So we have to do what? We cannot subtract smaller number to greater number. That's why we have to borrow 1/10 from the tens place. Students, you know the system of doing the subtraction. So I am cutting this 4. I am taking here 1/10 from the tens place, then 0 will become 10. And as I borrowed 1/10 from the 4, that's why 4 will become now 3. Okay, now it will become 10. 0 become 10. So 10 minus 5. What will be the answer here? Use your finger line. 10 minus 5. If you cut, then yes, it will be the 5. And now go to the next part. Upper part is 3. Here is what? Lower part is 8. So again, what we have to do? We cannot subtract smaller number to greater number. That's why again I have to borrow 100 from the 100 place. Then it will become what? It will become 13. And this 5 will become what? 4. Okay. So 13 minus 8, what will be there? Yes, 13 minus 8, if you use your finger line, we got the answer, what? 5, yes, another 5. So now go to the next part. Here is upper part is 4, lower part there is nothing. So this 4 we have to place there, 455 taka. It will be what? It will be the remaining taka. Okay, remaining. It will be our remaining taka. We got here remaining taka after spent 85 taka from 540 taka. We got the answer here, remaining taka. So students, I hope that now you will understand that we got the final answer here. What amount did she deposit in the bank? Because they are telling you remaining amount she deposited in the bank. And what will be the remaining taka here? Remaining taka is, we got 455. Okay, this is our final answer. We got the final answer here. So now I am writing our answer. She deposited. You know, answer you have to write. $455 taka in the bank. So now students, I hope that all of you have understood today's problem number 70. So now again I will make you understand. Then you will write it in your CW copy. You have to mention the topic number, CW number, page number. And look what I have written here. Everybody open your CW copy. All of you. The price of 1 dozen egg is taka 90. And the price of 6 dozen egg is, how can I find out? By doing the multiplication, we have to find out these things. Otherwise, how can I know that how much money she got from selling? That's why we have to do the multiplication here to find out the money she got from selling. And after selling, she got 540 taka. And they have told you from what she got, she spent taka 85 in the market. That's why she does not deposit all the money, 5, 140 taka in the bank. After spends, then she remaining money she deposited in the bank. That's why we have to find out the remaining money by doing the subtraction. Look, that's why I have written here, she has taka at first 540 and she spent from this taka 85, then her money will be less. That's why we are doing the subtraction here. After subtraction we doing writing the answer, remaining taka 455. Now it is our final answer, 455 taka is our final answer. So at last I have written the answer, she deposited 455 taka in the bank. So students, hope all of you have understood. Now I am giving you some time for writing it in the CW copy. Write it in your CW copy, all of you. So students, I hope that already you have finished writing. Okay, now it is time for what? Diary writing. So take out your diary and follow me. Whatever I am writing in the board. Today what is will be the SW number? Today SW number will be 4. So follow the board. Do from page, from the same page I am giving the diary, page 73, problem num 18. So it is our today's diary, SW4, do from page 73, problem num 18. So students, please take out your diary and write down this. Okay, do from page 73, problem num 18. My dear students, you are the backbone of our school, so you have some duties and responsibilities. Your first and foremost duty is to seek knowledge. So keep on learning and enjoy learning. No more today. Bye bye all of you and take care.